so far in my presentations, I've enjoyed it the most. I hope you people also will enjoy it. And for the first time, I'm adding violin to my show. I've never added violin to my show. Today is the first time. And so I need all your blessings for that. Now, we just spoke about magic squares. So I would like to, you know, I'm just telling you what I'm going to do. I would like to play the magic square on the violin in a different way. So it might look a little weird to you, but I'll tell it to you how it is possible. So first, let's do a new magic square. Do you want this here or can I rub it? I'll rub it. I hope all of you have verified all the sums and are sure that all of them add up to 51. Okay. So again, I need some audience participation. Can anybody give me four numbers that add up to 16? Any four numbers that add up to 16. You can have the same number come twice. But give me four numbers that they add up to 16.
8008.
8008, okay. Can we have a, no, we can remove the zeros and make it a little bit more interesting. Can anybody give me?
5353. But you can add this, the rows, columns, diagonals, corner numbers, center numbers, divide the square into four parts, take each of the groups of four. So all the things that I showed you in the old magic square work in this way. Now how can we play this on the violin? Does anybody have any suggestions before that? I'm just asking. You might have had some vivid imagination of how to play this on the violin when I first mentioned it. Does anybody have an idea of how to play this on the violin? How can we relate violin to this? Okay, so first, you might be knowing the Sapta Swaras, right? Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, and Sa. So let's assume 8. So instead of saying Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, I give them chords. For 1, I say Sa. For 2, I say Sa, Re. For 3, I say Sa, Re, Ga. For 4, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma. For 5, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa. For 6, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da. For 7, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni. And for 8, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, Sa. Okay? So instead of saying 5-3-5-3, I say Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Sa, Re, Ga, Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Sa, Re, Ga. Are you able to follow? Why Pa? Pa is the fifth swara. So we go up to that swara. And the sum is 16. So when we take 5-3-5-3, overall, all the swaras will add up to 16. So let's try. Sorry, I am going to use the Raga Shankara Bharana. It's very melodious and it has all the swara. So this is the raga. This is the raga Shankara Bharana. So let's say 5-3-5-3. Sarigama pa sariga, sarigama pa sariga. Okay? And all of them add up to 16. And next one is 1-7-7-1. Becomes Sa, Sarigama Padani, Sarigama Padani, and Sa. Are you able to follow? Simple, right? And the third row will be 1-2-3-4-5-6, 1-2, and 1-2-3-4-5-6, 7-8. We can leave the 0. So it becomes. The last row will be. Okay, now let's try the corners. 5-1-6-4. Next one will be 3-7-2-4. Next one 5-7-4. Are you able to follow? And the last row becomes 3-1-8-4. And now let's try the diagonals. 5-7-0-4 becomes. The the other diagonal from 3, 7, 2, 4. Okay, now let's play the four numbers in the center, 7, 7, and 2. Now we'll divide it into four groups. I'll play all four of them. So 1, 2, 3, 4. First one will be. The last is the four corners. On the stage. So this is how musicians can use violin in maths. So thank you.